This is the Sunco 709A pulse spot welding and soldering machine. It's a 110 version, has a US plug, and shipped out of the US warehouse. Comes with four of these welding electrodes, two of which are immediately needed in the head up here. The accessory spot welding pen and two spare tips for that. Two fuses, a wrench. There's about 50 pieces of metal here. This is nickel plated iron, and this is used for welding batteries together. A foot switch, which plugs in here, and this is used primarily with this welding pen. A soldering iron base. This is a nice base, it's cast iron, and this is threaded, and then it has a jam nut on it. It's heavy, you don't go chasing that around the workbench. And this is used for 18650 batteries when you're welding them together to make a battery pack. This is a very well-made box. It's held together with like 14 screws, and these are threaded connections. They are not sheet metal screws. These are a sheet metal screw. There's a label right here. It tells you if you open this up, the warranty is void. I like looking inside these things, see how they're made. I'm going to take mine apart so curiosity won't get the better of you. Pretty solid box on this. Not much of anything used or serviceable in here. Everything electronic is on a circuit board. And this is your tension adjustment. And all you're doing by adjusting that is putting more tension or less tension on this spring, which preloads this head. And that's going to be a personal preference for you. How much force do you want to be able to put on the battery, and what's your welding before this thing fires and does the spot welding? Down inside here is a micro switch. When you lift up on those two bars, you're going to trip that micro switch. When that micro switch closes, it's going to pulse your spot welder. When this trips, this will deliver a large amperage for just a few milliseconds. One thing they warn about is plug this into a good circuit, like 20 amp. Don't use a long, thin gauge extension cord. Don't plug it into an outlet with a bunch of other appliances running at the same time. And don't use one of those outlet adapters where you can plug three or four things into the one outlet. Specifications on some of these units can be confusing at best. This is the label on the back of my machine, and it's made for 110 volts AC, and it says it needs a 20 amp input. Somewhere else it'll say that the unit consumes 50 watts. This says that the output can be anywhere from 50 to 800 amps. It's also stated 3.2 kilowatt output instantaneous. So I wouldn't pay too much attention to that. My requirement for this welder is, does it weld leads onto batteries? And the answer to that is yes, it does, and it seems to do a very good job of it. When you install the electrodes, you want to adjust them so they protrude about the same amount, and it's flat across here. And you can angle these a little bit to decrease the spacing. For welding on a smaller battery, you get your two spot welds closer together. And your spring tension, that will adjust how much pressure you have to put against the battery for this to come up and activate that micro switch. These are your pulse settings. This will adjust how long the spot weld stays on. And this is your current setting. It goes from 1 to 8. That will require a bit of experimentation. This has a little dot here. I took a Sharpie and made a mark on there. It's easier to see. This is the temperature settings for your soldering iron. Your foot pedal switch plugs in here. Soldering iron. And this is the leads for your spot welding pin. This turns on the welding machine. It turns on this part right here. You have a light down here that illuminates what you're trying to spot weld if you're using this. your amperage adjustment. If you turn this on, that's a 4 pulse. That's an indication of a length of time, how long the spot weld will stay on. So a 4 pulse, a 6 pulse, an 8 pulse. You can turn on a 4 and a 6 and get 10. You can turn on a 6 and an 8 and get 14. You turn on all 3 of them, you get a pulse duration of 18. If you turn the switch off and you turn it back on again, you have to reset these. That's kind of a safety factor. Now this switch turns on your soldering iron. Soldering iron is not attached, so it doesn't come on. If we attach the soldering iron, turn on the machine, turn this on, light comes on, and now we can adjust the temperature of the soldering iron. And the soldering iron, it heats up pretty quick. There is a little sample spot weld that comes with the machine. It shows that the machine was tested, it does work. And it's got the machine number on here. And it gives you some examples of what the settings might be for welding stainless steel or nickel plated steel. And that will just require a little bit of trial and error and some practice on your part. I did not receive an instruction book with this. And this is pretty much trial and error, learning how this works and trying to decipher some of the things that are written on the website. They do refer on the website to 2 pulses. Well, the only thing here is 4, 6, and 8. So I did try welding a battery with none of these selected. And this, I assume, is where you get 2 pulses. And it did quite a good job of welding at 7, and none of these turned on. This will be my second spot weld. So I'm trying a 4 pulse. And I have my current set to about 7. And I have angled these together a little bit closer in case I want to weld on the top of this battery. Now, this is just an old Penlight battery and a fairly wide piece of nickel-plated steel, nickel-plated iron. I put that on there. This machine is pretty heavy. And I have the weight or the tension or the pressure adjusted about mid-range on this. And then and that fired. And that's a pretty good weld. Now I can take a pair of pliers and I can pull that off of there. But that's not going to come off by itself. And I can turn and I can do that again. It would be a very good idea to wear safety glasses while you're doing this. All of my outlets out here in the shop are 20 amp, and I don't expect to have a problem with this at all. It'd be real handy if you want to make a temporary battery pack out of some flashlight batteries. You can spot weld those together, and then you can solder to this strip. I get a hold of this with a pair of pliers. I can pull that off there, but in the process I have torn a hole in that strip and it has left pieces of metal on the battery. So you take a file, you can smooth that off again. But that's a pretty good weld, and it certainly serves the purpose. These electrodes are consumables. You may want to order a few spares. When you saw that flash, some of the end of the electrode is burned away. You're going to burn these away in any case, but with a flash like that, it's going to burn away faster. So you want to practice pushing on those squarely and make sure you have contact with both of those before you do the spot weld. And if you have a lathe, you could turn this back a little bit here. These are long enough to be dressed back several times. I have these electrodes about the same length now. One thing I haven't pointed out, this head will allow for some differential movement to compensate for uneven length or surface. But generally speaking, you should try to keep these as much the same as possible. When you're welding a strip onto a battery, The spring tension in this head, or in the pen, is pushing down on this strip and creating good contact between the electrodes, the strip, and the battery. And when you push up on here and activate the micro switch, the current flow is down through one electrode to a very small point of contact through this strip and back up through the opposite electrode. And those two points get real hot. There's a lot of current for the size of contact that gets white hot and welds those together. The current flow is through here. It's not through the battery. So the point of the weld gets hot, but the battery does not get hot. You need to sneak up on your settings. Gradually increase your pulse or your duration of the weld, and gradually increase your amperage. Experimentation. Learn how to run the machine. This is a spot welding pen, and this allows you to get further away from the machine. If you're welding something that's deeper than about an inch or an inch and an eighth, you can't do it on the machine. And this allows you to reach further into your project and do the spot weld. When you push this down, these are spring loaded. And when you push that down on your battery, and that's holding your nickel plated steel strap or whatever onto the battery with that spring pressure, then you use your foot to initiate the switch and it gives you the spot weld. Now this is spring loaded. Pressing that down on the metal strap that you're welding onto your battery or whatever it is you're spot welding, that puts pressure against the metal piece and holds it firm against the battery, and then you use the foot switch to fire the spot weld. And this thing here is a little bit adjustable, and if I pull this out, it brings these two tips closer together. If I push it in, these are a little further apart. So I can adjust the spacing like that. So I have a new Volunteer Penlite battery. We're going to weld this strip on here using the welding pen. And I have this set at 10 pulse, and I've turned the current all the way up, mainly because these leads are longer and to get more power to these small electrodes. When I push these down on here, I'm going to be using the foot switch, and I want you to watch these cables jump. When you see welding electrodes jump like that, that's an indication of high amperage pulse. Made two welds across there, and that's a very good weld. That's on there solid. So a welding pen will be quite handy. The connections for the pen are very good. This is a very firm to push that in, and you got to wiggle it a little bit to get it out. So those are good.